If we click on the Fontwork Shape tool, it shows us a toolbar that we can tear off and move to the side. Let's take a look at some of these shapes here. I'm going to pick this Fade Left. Makes the text small on the left side and large on the right. We also have our little yellow ball there that I can make it smaller or larger. And this can also be accentuated by the width of our box. If I make this a little smaller and wider, and then I can adjust it a little more. Depending on the look we're trying to achieve, we may want to adjust more than just the yellow ball is what I'm getting at. Sometimes if we adjust the frame itself of the font work, we can intensify the effect. These two arches look very similar. Let's take a look at the difference between them. Taking a look at this arch up curve, this looks like a nice half circle, everything evenly spaced out here. If I move my yellow dot in or out, nothing happens. Only up gives me less of an arch. And if I move it down, need to get the hand, we get a big circle. And this would also be affected by how much I move my box. Now let's take a look at this arch up pour. Now with the yellow dot, if I move it up, makes it smaller, but I can also adjust the size of the text. Bringing it into the circle, taking it back out. If I move my yellow dot to the other side, I've got things all upside down. Which is different than this upside down arch, because when it's upside down here, my text is still right side up. When I'm on my other arch, if I move my text over the halfway mark, it goes upside down. And the same thing happens here. So if you want some real crazy text, you can make it upside down and backwards. When we click off our font work, most of our toolbars go away. We still have our font work shape. And when I click back on it, we have our font work, and we also have our drawing object properties toolbar. If you don't see it, go to View, Toolbars, and there it is, Drawing Object Properties. There's a few things on this toolbar I'd like to look at. First one being the line style. This line style will be for our text. I haven't found a lot of these useful. If we click on like these big dashes, you can't even tell what we're writing there. But something like this ultra fine dash, that looks okay. And we also have this dashed variable. Our next box over is the line width, and you can make it thicker. Sometimes make it too thick though, you can't tell what it is. Even if I go back to that continuous line, it's a little smudgy. Depending on your font style and the font work shape you picked, you may find thicker lines more useful than other times. This next one is the color of our font work text. We can make it blue, make it red, we'll make it red. Let's make this line a little thinner though. The next thing I want to look at is this rotation button. Clicking that, we see our blue boxes turn to red circles. When I put my arrow over it, it becomes a circular line with arrows on each end. When I drag that circle, it allows me to move my font work in a circle. Actually, it's just rotating around this rotation point. If I move the rotation point over this Y, it will allow me to rotate around the Y. If I move this rotation point to the O in computer, I can rotate around the O. I'm going to move the rotation point back down. Now I'm going to make the view smaller so we can see it on the page. My rotation point's way over here now. We bring that down, and I can place it anywhere on the page. It does not have to be in my font work box. So my rotation point's way down here. When I go up to the corner, you can see that it's rotating around my rotation point. Now these center circles do a little bit different than the corners. Moving that moves it from side to side, and depending on our font work shape, it may move it differently. But for this one, it just moves it side to side. And you can see that the bottom, top, and the sides do the same thing. And if the rotation point's out on the side or move back in the center, these middle circles do the same thing. Thank you.